Terry Jacobson, Marketing Artfully. So today I want to talk about how, like why your Etsy shop sales may be slow. So one of the things that I see happen every summer, and it's the middle of summer now, is people freak out. Etsy sellers freak out. They start talking about how Etsy has hidden their shop, how they always sell a lot, and there's a conspiracy. So there's no conspiracy. Your shop is going to have seasonal ups and downs. So we're going to talk about three things that could be why your shop is having a slump. So number one is seasonality. So if you look at this blog post, and I'll include it in the description, Google Trends is awesome. Okay, so Google Trends. Boop, 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 boop. Okay. That's the song for our little dog. Sorry, I didn't mean to sing it to you. Okay, so if we do a search for planners, okay, in my one shop I sell planners, and we go over the last 5 years, we're gonna see that January, December, January, December through January, depending on when that week came about. So if I got all twisted every year in July that nobody is buying my planners, that would be a little crazy, right? So a couple things you can do. You can add other things to planners. Like I have a summer to-do list. I have other things that I get have in my shop so that if it's not July, so there is a little thing in here, maybe August. So you, okay. If you're freaking out that you sell planners, you could sell teacher planners, you could sell student planners. You could try to figure out things through the year that would help you from crashing, right? But I can't be upset that nobody's buying planners in July because from my shop, because nobody's buying planners in July from the internet. So that is super important to know, right? Okay, so what other kinds of things happen? If you're looking seasonally, it's so funny. Everybody else has this amazing December. They're like, oh my gosh, we're gonna, you know, make so much money between December 1st and December, you know, 20th when you can stop shipping and whatever. And honestly, you guys, my vintage shop goes, I have really good Novembers, I have really good Octobers, but my December is just nothing. And the first year it happened, I was devastated. I was like, but wait, it's Christmas. And then I realized I sell some things that are good and I do sell stuff. I'm not saying I don't sell anything, but I don't have this Christmas hullabaloo. But I sell mostly things that people perhaps would be buying for themselves. I sell things for artists and I don't think anybody goes, oh, I would buy my mom a ratty old, you know, paintbrush to give to her for Christmas, even though that's what her mom wants. I don't sell new things. So I really have this kind of weird bump in January. Like people get their gift cards and then they buy my stuff. So you need to track over time also what your shop seasonality and what your shop inventory is. Number two is bad reviews. If you have bad reviews, you need to fix them. So one of the things that I see people getting bad reviews for is that their items break in transit or they ship slow or, you know, you need to make sure that you're fixing any of those problems that you have. And then if you have a response, like I had this cute little old man, I love him. He's my only one star review. And I sent it to him and there was no response. I didn't know whether something happened to him. I emailed him every once in a while, said, do you want a refund? Do you want me to send it? What do you want me to do? And probably I should have just refunded him and, you know, closed it out or whatever, but I didn't. And so he sent me a one-star review instead of contacting me. So I finally tracked him down. I'm like, what's up? And he sent me a delightful picture of his project that he had finished. He's a super nice man. He just wanted his money back. But I did put a note on there, you know, that I had contacted the gentleman and that we had a rate, you know, of course I gave him a full refund. And so that has not affected my sales. But if it's your fault you're getting bad reviews, fix that. If it's just beyond your control, then respond to it to the people that are going to be coming. And last but not least, if your shop is slow, the only way I know to kickstart a shop, so this is my biggest hack, is to list, right? So you need to do new listings. As soon as I start doing listings within a week or two, my shop starts picking up. It's easy for me because I'm a vintage person. I understand that completely. The mailman's coming, so we're hurrying. So it's easy for me. But for people who sell handcrafted or handmade, you could do bundles, you could do color variations, you could do all kinds of things. What you need to do is keep listing other items. And I have a post I'll link to. I'm going to make a little note of that. Post about multiples. Okay, I did a post about this. There's one shop that sells like 12 things, and they have 260 listings because what they do is they offer it different ways. And as long as you have the ability to fulfill your listings, you're allowed to do that per the Etsy terms of service. So hopefully that helps. Tara Jacobson, Marketing Artfully.